No, Italy's Campi Flegrei Volcano, in my opinion as a geologist, is not about to produce some catastrophic volcanic eruption or very high magnitude earthquake. No large groups of people have been evacuated and the earth isn't literally cracking open there. But if you didn't frequent my channel and instead watch specific other sources, you might instead feel fear, anxiety, and other strong emotions due to harmful and inaccurate claims about the volcano's ongoing unrest. Before I debunk a bunch of these claims, I want to say the following. Regarding Campi Flegrei, the misinformation you are seeing online about it is actually the manifestation of YouTube and the larger social media ecosphere's commoditization of fear and division. Content creators can make far more money by exaggerating or outright lying about risks, clickbait, or causing controversy as these all increase the view count. When creators do this, it dumbs humanity down and leaves people in an unnecessary state of constant fear and panic. If a purported news source is constantly leaving you in a state of fear, anger, or anxiety after watching it, they may, in my opinion, just be using you to enrich themselves since strong emotions drive viewership. With that out of the way, let's debunk some of the inaccurate claims that have been made regarding this volcano located 11 kilometers west of the city center of Naples. The most common claim suggests that Campi Flegrei will soon erupt and that people should evacuate now or soon. This is absolute nonsense. Campi Flegrei undergoes cycles that are fairly predictable in the long term and we are not yet in the potential pre-eruption stage. If we were, there would be more than 2 meters of yearly uplift rate for more than 4 months straight instead of the meager 18 centimeters a year of uplift it is right now. In other words, Campi Flegrei is currently in this stage, which I want to remind everyone lasted for 136 years before moving into the subsequent stage. Campi Flegrei isn't erupting in the next decade, in my opinion, unless something dramatic and unexpected rapidly changes. What about claims that this volcano will soon produce a caldera-forming eruption like seen at Pinatubo in 1991? Soon and will are quite strong in unscientific terms. Yes, there is some evidence that suggests Campi Flegrei is approaching the end of its more than 10,000-year-long cycle, which has in the past culminated in major caldera-forming eruptions. However, if that were the case, and that is a big if, it would in my opinion be a potential problem multiple hundreds or even thousands of years from now. And I am not so sure because there does not appear to be enough eruptible magma at shallow depths to generate a caldera-forming eruption at the present or within that stated time frame. Also, I suggest not relying purely on past data in a complex system to predict the future, as doing that often leads to incorrect interpretations, whether that be in volcanoes, the stock market, etc. What about reports of fumaroles and or gas vents having recently appeared in specific spots that are now melting through minor patches of road? Such reports are completely true, but are quite limited in scope, and this information is being completely taken out of context. Now, I know this isn't exactly the best comparison to reassure people with, but the same thing commonly occurs in other large caldera complexes with highly active geothermal systems such as Yellowstone in Wyoming. And, you know, Yellowstone is physically incapable of erupting for at least another 10,000 years at a minimum. And yet, fumaroles, mud pots, geothermal areas, and such commonly appear and disappear or even move over time. The same occurs at Campi Flegrei, just far more people live in the aforementioned caldera complex. This activity at Campi Flegrei really isn't all that special. I mean, you can even find a recent example of the same thing occurring at the Sultan Buttes volcano in California, and that probably isn't erupting anytime soon. However, these geothermal vent changes do occur at a higher rate during periods of volcanic unrest, and Campi Flegrei has been undergoing one such phase of unrest since 2005 involving near-continuous ground uplift, with a raised alert level of yellow being maintained since December 2016. What about the cracks that have appeared in some structures? These are mostly the result of earthquake damage in the last 3 years on primarily brick structures, which are a specific low height most susceptible to seismic resonance from the volcanic earthquakes and are built on top of rock units that amplify earthquake ground motion. Other cracks are formed by the uplift unevenly pushing a structure upwards or outwards horizontally. This activity has occurred before without leading to an eruption, such as in the 1980s. Once again, sounds scary, but really not all that special. Tomorrow, in my next part discussing Campi Flegrei, I will give my thoughts on what is actually causing its current unrest without the clickbait nonsense or lies of some other sources, while also debunking some other nonsensical claims.